Which is the second most serious and sinful act which invalidates the fast during Ramadan?
The second most serious thing that breaks the fast or invalidates the fast, it is masturbation. And this we get from the hadith of our beloved Prophet Muhammad, that's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 3, in the book of fasting, hadith number 1894, where the Prophet said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that all the deeds of the son of Adam are for himself, except for fasting. It's for me, and I will reward him. And further he says that the person, he leaves, he abstains from eating and drinking and his desires for my sake. Allah says, the person abstains from eating, drinking, and his desires for my sake. Now this desire, from here we come to know, it includes even masturbation. So when a person masturbates or ejaculates, whether by touching his wife or looking at his wife, or for other reason, or looking at any other woman, and if an ejaculation takes place, then the fast gets invalidated. He has to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and complete that day of fasting, and he should compensate for this fast, keep this fast later after the Ramadan gets over. But here, there's no kafara, there's no penalty. Well, that penalty is only for a sexual intercourse. Here, because the intercourse hasn't taken place, there is no penalty. You should only repent, make up that fast you should complete, and then make up for that fast later on. But if a person does not ejaculate, and if there is madi which comes out, fluid, then the fast does not break. Similarly, this is the prostatic fluid, the madi. And if the madi comes out, that is after urination, a white fluid, then too the fast does not break. Only thing he has to do is istinja. He should wash the private parts and do wudu. The fast does not break. He can complete the fast and continue the fast.
I think that would be very useful for a lot of people living in the West, and may Allah protect us from following our desires to that level, inshallah.